Good afternoon and a very warm welcome back to the Petronas Sepang International Circuit. The pressure is on at the top. Martin's 157.997 is bettered. Brilliant job that by Alex Marquez. Look what that means to Grazzini Ducati. That was some lap, wasn't it, by the Spanish rider. 157.823. That's only a whisker away from Jorge Martin's all-time lap record. What a lap. What a Friday that was for Alex Marquez.
That is impressive.
Yeah, superb job that by the Grazzini racing rider. Martin does find the first 157 of day one here in Malaysia. He led the entire field this morning at the end of FP1. Second quickest this afternoon. Just two riders found laps in the 157s this afternoon. Yeah, well done, Jorge. Job done, mate. Over the line, Bagnaia comes. Is it going to be P4 or better? It is P4. Bagnaia's got through then. Having been in Q1 in two of the last three Grand Prix, he'll be happy with that, a 158.420.
Well, it looks like Brad's pushing on. Brad's doing a good slide there before changing direction. I don't think it was a lose. I think he did that on purpose.
A 158.731 was surely Binder's earlier 158.310. That's going to see him comfortably advance directly into Q2.
Oh, Jack Miller on a good one as well.
Thriller Miller finds a 158.232. And he's got one more lap as well here, the Australian. So Miller puts his KTM up inside the top three.
Lots of fans here. So good to see Jack going fast like we know he can do.
Brilliant by the fact Patrick KTMs, Miller and Binder third and fourth respectively. You can just see there, I wonder if that's that part of the solutions that Aprilia were talking about, some way of getting some cooler air maybe onto their riders here this weekend. They've had very little time, of course, to try and find a remedy to the chronic heat problems that beset all four Aprilia riders. The yellow flags are out in the fourth sector. It's a laser spark.
Oh, that's on fire. Oh,
that bike is on fire. So they've had their problems dissipating the heat in Buriram a couple of weeks ago. Well, there's still going to be problems with the heat on that RSGP. So Alessio Spargo just stayed committed there, didn't he? Ran really, really wide.
It's going to be as he approaches it. Yeah, get away from that, Alessio. Yeah.
That was not what he wanted to see, yeah. Alessio Spargo, second fall of the day for the Aprilia man, it is. That's in the first corner.
See, yeah, just lost the front. Hit a big lean angle.
I can't believe my eyes. Alessio Spargo, for the third time on this opening day of this Petronas Grand Prix in Malaysia, has thrown the Aprilia RSGP at the scenery.
Yeah, just not being able to feel the grip on the edge there for some reason.
Alessio Spargo again. It's crash number four. It's time for a lazy thing to park it, sleep on it tonight, and then come back tomorrow. This is a fast one. The most experienced rider in MotoGP, 34 years of age. This is Alesia's 319th Grand Prix start. Yeah, he's been on the floor four times on day one here today. A Friday to forget for Alesia Spargaro. Now, if Vinales can carry this lap on through on this factory of brilliance, surely he's going into top spot. Vinales goes up to third. Well, we need a shot of Lynn Jarvis right now, don't we, inside that factory Yamaha garage, because Frankie Morbidelli led the way and Fabio Quartararo has gone up into second place.
That's a good sign for them so far.
Fabio Quartararo, job done for the Frenchman. He always says his initial target, the opening goal of a Grand Prix weekend these days, is just to make sure he goes into Q2 directly.
That was a save and a half.
What a save that was, on his knee and his elbow through turn nine. That was astonishing by the Italian, who missed out on the top 10 by just under 0.09 of a second in 11th.
Oh, his teammate in his way, was it or not?
Well, Fabio clearly thinks he was.
Oh no.
To see more from the biggest MotoGP season ever, click here to subscribe.